Hello children, our topic is multinational companies in chapter 9, globalization. Before going into the lesson, let us see what is globalization.
Today we can get Alfonso from India, coffee from Brazil and wine from France sitting at our homes because of something called international trade. Traders are extending their areas of business by seeing the world as a global market. Countries are coming together as one big global economy. This is called economic globalization. Globalization refers to international trade being less obstructed by national borders. Globalization is the process of growing, developing, and expanding the business, services, and technologies across the globe. It's like considering the whole world as a single market.
Children, after watching this video, you have understood that globalization is a major change that occurred across the globe in the late 20th century. This has political, cultural, as well as economic dimensions. Let us focus mostly on the economic aspects of globalization. Until the middle of the 20th century, production was largely organized within countries. Raw materials, food grains, and finished products only crossed the boundaries of these countries. India at that time was a colonial country. It exported raw materials and food grains and imported finished goods. Trade was the main channel connecting distant countries before the emergence of multinational corporations. Children, let us learn about these multinational companies in lesson. What is an MNC? An MNC is a company that owns or controls production in more than one nation. MNCs set up offices and factories for production in regions where they can get cheap labor and other resources. This is done so that the cost of production is low and the MNCs can earn greater profits. Let us see the example of a large MNC producing industrial equipment. A large MNC producing industrial equipment designs its products in research centers in United States, and its components are manufactured in China. These are then shipped to Mexico and Eastern Europe, where the products are assembled and the finished products are sold all over the world. The company's customer care is carried out through call centers located in India. Through this example, we have understood that the MNC is not only selling its finished products globally, but more important is that the goods and services are also being produced globally. As a result, production is organized in increasingly complex ways. The production process is divided into small parts and spread out across the globe. If we observe the example, the country China provides a cheap manufacturing location. Mexico and Eastern European countries are useful for their closeness to the markets in the US and Europe. And our country India has educated English speaking youth who can provide customer care services. By this, the cost of saving for the MNCs can be 50 to 60%, and many advantages are there for the MNCs for spreading out production across the borders. Interlinking production across countries. Now, let us see how the MNCs interlink production across the countries. MNCs interlink production across countries. Their main goal is to earn profits. In order to earn more profits, they select the site for operations of MNCs accordingly. They select the sites which are closer to the markets, where they get skilled and unskilled labor at low cost. Availability of other factors of production such as land, building, machines, etc. are assured to them, and liberal government policies to protect their interests. The money that the MNCs spend to buy assets such as land, building, machines and other equipment is called foreign investment. After selecting the site, MNCs set up production jointly with the local companies. This is beneficial for the both. MNCs are benefited by immediate marketing, and the local company benefits by additional investments and the latest technology brought by the MNCs. Sometimes MNCs buy these local companies and take over their markets. One such example is Cargill Food, a large American MNC. It has bought over smaller Indian companies such as Parag Foods. There is another way in which MNCs control production. Large multinational companies in developed countries place orders for productions with small producers. Garments, footwear, sports items are examples of industries where production is carried out by a large number of small producers around the world. The products are supplied to the MNCs, which then sell them under their own brand name to the customers. These large MNCs determine the price, quality, delivery and labor conditions for these distant producers. Because of the MNCs, production in widely dispersed locations is getting interlinked. Now children, it is time for evaluation. Improve your learning by answering these questions. First one, what is an MNC? Second, what do you mean by foreign investment? Third question, write down the advantages and disadvantages of multinational companies. And the fourth question is, what is the criteria for selecting site for MNCs? Fifth question, give a picture of production across countries before large MNCs. Thank you for watching.